Lord, have mercy.
For
this holy temple for them with faith, reverence, and the fear of God and to hear him. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the Orthodox Episcopal, the persecuted Russian Church, for our Lord, the very most reverend Archbishop Tikhon, for our Lord, the most reverend Bishop Stefan, for the venerable priest of the Diaconate of Christ, for the clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the suffering Russian land, its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and in the diaspora, for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this land, its God-free authorities and armed forces, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That he may deliver his people from the bitter torment of the godless authority and confirm in us oneness of mind, brotherly love, and piety, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this town, for every city and country, the faithful dwell therein, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For seasonable weather, abundance of the fruits of the earth, and peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For traveling by sea, men and air, for the sick, the suffering, the imprisoned, for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be delivered from all tribulation, wrath, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, sinners, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remember to our most holy, most fearless, blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God.
Worthy.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Mercy.
Help us, Jesus, have mercy as you keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Awake your remembrance, O most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious, Lady Theotokos, the ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints. Let us pray ourselves and one another all our life unto Christ our God.
Through thee, O Lord.
Blessed be the light of the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father.
Trinity, for he did not say. meditation into thy word.
My soul hath hope in the Lord. We have seen the true light. We have received the heavenly Spirit. We have found the true faith in worshiping the indivisible Trinity. For he hath saved us.
From the morning watch to the night, from the morning watch,
let Israel hope in the Lord. In the prophets thou hast proclaimed unto us the way of salvation, and the grace of thy Spirit hath shown in the apostles, O our Savior. Now our God, who art from the beginning, and for time to come and unto the ages, thou art our God.
With the Lord there is mercy, with him is plenteous redemption.
And he shall redeem Israel out of all his iniquities. In thy courts shall I praise thee, the Savior of the world, and bending my knee I shall worship thy invincible might. In the evening, in the morning, bidding, and at all times shall I bless thee, O Lord.
O praise the Lord, all ye nations.
Praise him, all ye peoples. In thy courts, O Lord, as we the faithful bend the knee of the soul and the body, we praise thee, the beginningless Father, the co-beginning, the Son, and the co-eternal, and the Holy Spirit, who does enlighten and sanctify our souls.
For he hath made his mercy to prevail over us,
and the truth of the Lord abideth forever. Let us praise the consubstantial Trinity, the Father and the Son, with the Holy Spirit. For thus did all the prophets and apostles preach to the Lord.
For he will now be told.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Holy peoples, let us worship the God and the three Lord Moses, the Son, and the Father, with the Holy Spirit. For the Father that received me as the Son, who is co-eternal and the Father, and the Holy Spirit was in the Father, glorified with the Son, one man, one essence, one Godhead, which we all worship, say, Holy God, we just read all things through the Son, with the cooperation of the Holy Spirit. Holy Mighty, through whom we have come the Father, and through whom the Holy Spirit came to the world. Holy Immortal, the Comforting Spirit, who proceedeth from the Father and rests in the Son. Holy Trinity, glory be.
Wisdom arise.
70 men from the elders of the people and set them round about the tabernacle. And the Lord came down in a cloud and spake unto Moses and took up the spirit that was upon him and gave it unto the 70 men that were elders. And it came to pass that when the spirit rested upon them, they prophesied in the camp and they ceased. But there remained two of the men in the camp. The name of the one was Eldad and the name of the other Modad. And the spirit rested upon them, and they were of them that were written, but went not out unto the tabernacle, and they prophesied in the camp. And there ran a young man and told Moses and spake unto him, saying, Eldad and Modad prophesy in the camp. And Jesus, his chosen one, the son of Nabi, who attended unto Moses, answered and said, My Lord Moses forbid them. And Moses said unto him, Art thou envious for my sake? Would that all the Lord's people were prophets, whenever the Lord should put his spirit upon them.
Wisdom.
The reading from the prophecy of Joel.
Bless them.
Thus saith the Lord, Be glad, ye children of Zion, and rejoice in the Lord your God, for he hath given you food justly, and he will rain on you the early and the latter rain as before. And the threshing floor shall be full of wheat, and the vat shall overflow with wine and oil. And I will recompense you for the years that the locust hath taken, and the cankerworm and caterpillar, and the palmer worm, my great army which I sent among you. And ye shall eat and be nourished, and shall be satisfied, and shall praise the name of the Lord your God that hath dealt wondrously with you. My people shall never be put to shame. And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel, and I am the Lord your God, and that there is none other beside me. And my people shall never be put to shame. And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, your old men shall dream dreams, and your young men shall see visions. For upon my servants and upon my handmaids in those days will I pour out of my spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show dread marvels in the heavens above, and signs upon the earth below, blood and fire and vapor of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before the great and the notable day of the Lord come. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Wisdom.
The reading of the prophecy of Ezekiel.
Let us attend.
Thus saith the Lord, I will take you from among the nations and gather you out of all countries and will bring you into your own land. I will sprinkle clean water upon you, and you shall be clean from all your filthiness and from all your idols, and I will cleanse you. And I will give you a new heart, and a new spirit will I give you. And I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and I will give you a heart of flesh, and I will put my spirit within you and cause you to walk in my statutes, and ye shall keep my judgments and do them. And ye shall dwell in the land that I gave to your fathers, and ye shall be my people, and I will be your God.
Stay with our whole soul and our whole mind, let us sing.
Mercy.
O Lord Almighty, the God of our fathers, we pray thee hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to thy great mercy, we pray thee hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for the Orthodox Episcopal of the Persecuted Russian Church. For our Lord, the very most reverend Archbishop Tikhon, for our Lord, the most reverend Bishop Stefan, and all my brethren in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the suffering Russian land and Orthodox people, both in the homeland and in the diaspora, for their salvation.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for this land of God-free authorities and our forces.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray to the Lord our God that he may deliver his people from the bitter torment of the godless authority and confirm in us oneness of mind, brotherly love, and piety.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the blessed and ever memorable holy founders of this holy temple, and for our fathers and brethren, God to the rest before us, the Orthodox here and everywhere, laid to rest.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon and remission of the sins of the servants of God, the brethren of this holy temple.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for them that bring offerings and do good works in this holy and all venerable temple, for them that minister and them that chant, for all the people here present to the way of thee, great and abundant mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For merciful and benevolent God art thou, and in thee we send our glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Vouchsafe, O Lord, to keep us this evening without sin. Blessed art thou, Lord, the God of our fathers, who praised and glorified us thy name into the ages. Amen. Let thy mercy, O Lord, be upon us according as we have hoped in thee. Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me thy statutes. Blessed art thou, Master, give me understanding of thy statutes. Blessed art thou, Holy One, enlighten me by thy statutes. O Lord, thy mercy endureth forever. Stay not the work of thy hand. To thee is due praise, to thee is due a song, to thee glory is due to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Let us complete our evening prayer to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
That the whole evening may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask for the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
An angel of peace, a faithful guide, the guide of our souls and bodies, let us ask to the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
Pardon and remission of our sins and offenses, let us ask to the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
Peace good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask to the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask to the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
A Christian in eternal life, aimless, blameless, peaceful, a good defense for the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask.
Grant this, O Lord.
Calling to remembrance our most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, Let us commit ourselves and one another in all life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O
Lord. Good and loving Lord God, and thee we send our glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and in the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be to all.
And to thy Spirit.
Let us bow our heads unto the Lord.
Blessed and most glorious be the beginning of thy kingdom, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the age of ages.
Prophets, thou hast proclaimed unto us the way of salvation, and the grace of thy Spirit hath shown in the apostles of our Savior. Thou art God, who art from the beginning, and for time to come, and into the ages, thou art our God. In thy court shall I praise thee, the Savior of the world, and bending my knee, I shall worship thy invincible mind. In the evening, in the morning, in day, and all times shall I bless thee, O Lord. In thy courts, O Lord, as we the faithful bethany of the soul and the body, we praise thee, the beginningless Father, the co-beginningless Son, the co-eternal Holy Spirit, who has enlightened and sanctified our souls. Glory to God, and we are so
exalt the horn of Orthodox Christians and send down upon us thine abundant mercies through the intercessions of our Immaculate Lady Theotokos and Ever Virgin Mary through the power of the precious and life-giving cross, through the mediation of the Honorable Heavenly Bodiless Host of the Honorable Glorious Prophet Forerunner at Baptist John, the Holy, Glorious, and All-Praised Apostles, of our Fathers among the Saints, the Great Ecumenical Teachers and Hierarchs, Basil Great, Gregory the Theologian and John Chrysostom, of our Father among the Saints, Nicholas the Wonder Worker, Archbishop of Myra and Lycia, of the Holy Equals, the Apostles, Methodius and Kirill, Teachers of the Slavs, of the Holy and Right Believing and Equal of the Apostles, Great Prince Vladimir, and of the Blessed Great Princess of Russia, Olga, of our Fathers among the Saints, the Wonder Workers of all Russia, Michael, Peter, Alexis, Jonah, Philip, Macarius, Dimitri, Mitrofan, Tikhon, and Theodosius, Yosef, Herod, Megan, Peter, Menasin, and John, of the Holy Heart Martyrs and Confessors, Tikhon, Patriarch of Moscow, Vladimir of Kiev, Benjamin of Petrograd, and Joseph of Petrograd, whose temple this is, Peter of Kratitsa, Kirill of Kazan, Agathangel of Yaroslav, Andronikos of Perm, Hermogenes of Tobolsk, the priest, John, Peter, and Phyllis all, and all the new higher martyrs and confessors of the Russian Church, the holy and glorious and victorious martyrs, the holy and glorious great martyr, trophy bearer, wonder worker George, the holy great martyr and healer, Pantaleon, the holy great martyr, Barbara, the holy right believing Russian princes and passion bearers, Boris and Glavin Igor, and the holy right believing passion bearers, our martyr Nicholas, our martyr Alexandra, the martyr crown prince Alexis, and the royal martyrs Olga, Tatiana, Maria, and Anastasia, and the holy nun martyrs, Grand Duchess Elizabeth and Nun Barbara, and all the new martyrs of Russia, believe God, Mary, Father, and Sergius the Abbot of Radonezh and Serpim of Saro, Job, Abbot of Wonder Worker of Pachai of the Holy Righteous, John of Krashta, the Holy Blessed Xenian of our Holy and God bearing Fathers, Herman of Alaska, Paisi Velichkovsky, Leo Macarius, Ambrose, and the other elders of Optina, the Hyrax, Edison of Moscow, Nicholas of Japan, John of Shanghai and San Francisco, Philaret of New York, Katrina of Lesna, and of the descent of the Holy Spirit upon the apostles, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, we pray thee, O Lord, plenteous in mercy. Hearken unto us sinners that pray unto thee, and have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, 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 Lord, have mercy. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Again, we pray for the Orthodox Episcopal, the persecuted Russian Church, for our Lord, the Most Reverend Archbishop Tikhon, for our Lord, the Most Reverend Bishop Stefan, and all our brethren in Christ, and for every Christian soul that is afflicted and tormented in need of the mercy and help of God, for the protection of this city, this town, and all that dwell therein, for the peace and welfare of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, for the salvation and help of our fathers and brethren that labor with zeal in the fear of God, for them that are absent and abroad, for the health of them that are bedridden in infirmities, for the repose, refreshment, blessed memory, and remission of sins of all our fathers and brethren that have departed before us in the Orthodox here and everywhere laid to rest, for the deliverance of the imprisoned, for our brethren that are serving, and for all that serve and have served in this holy temple, let us say,
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Again, we pray for the suffering Russian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and in the diaspora, for their salvation. For this land, its God-fearing authorities and armed forces, and every Christian land, let us say,
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Again, we pray that this town and this holy temple and every city and country may be preserved from famine, pestilence, earthquake, flood, fire, the sword, the invasion of aliens, and civil war, that our good and man-loving God may be gracious and favorable, that he may take away all the wrath stirred up against us and deliver us from his righteous threatening, which hangeth over us, and have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray also that the Lord God may hearken unto the voice of the supplication of us sinners and have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, merciful and thy loving God, hearken unto us, O God, our Savior, hope of all the ends of the earth, and those be far off at sea, and be merciful, Master, regarding our sins, and have mercy on us. For our merciful and man loving God, our God, unto thee we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be to all.
And to thy Spirit.
Let us bow our heads unto the Lord.
O Master, plenteous in mercy, O Lord Jesus Christ, our God, through the intercessions of Immaculate, Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, through the power of the precious and life-giving cross, through the mediation of the Honorable Heavenly Bodiless Host of the Honorable Glorious Prophet, Father, and Baptist John, of the Holy Glorious Laudable Apostles, our fathers among the saints and great academic teachers and hierarchs, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, and John Chrysostom, of our Father among the saints, Nicholas the Wonderworker, Archbishop of the Eastern Lycee, of the Holy Holy Apostles, Nicodemus the Real, teachers of the spots, of the Holy Right, believing equally Apostles, Great Prince Vladimir, and the Blessed Princes of Russia, Olga, of our fathers among the saints, the Wonderworkers of all Russia, Michael, Peter, Alexis, Jonah, Philip, Hermogenes, Macarius, Demetrius, Mitrophon, Tichon, Theodosia, Joseph, Agrinus, and then John, of the Holy Hierarch, Martyrs, and Confessors, Tichon, Patriarch of Moscow, Vladimir of Kiev, Benjamin of Petrograd, Joseph of Petrograd, Peter of Katitsa, Kirill of Kazan, Agafangri, Yaroslavl, Andronika, Perm, Hermogenes of the Bolst, the priest, John, Peter, and Philosoph, and all the new higher martyrs and confessors of Russia, of the holy, glorious, victorious martyrs, the holy, glorious, great martyr, trophy baron, wonderful George, the holy, great martyr, Hila Pavlim, the holy, great martyr, Barbara, of the holy, right, good evening, Russian princes and passion bearers, Boris, Glav, and Igor, the holy, right, believing passion bearers, Tsar Mata Nikolai, Tsaritsa, Alexander, the Tsarevich, Alexei, the royal martyrs, Olga, Tatiana, Maria, and Anastasia, of the holy, venerable nun martyrs, Grand Duchess Elizabeth and nun Barbara, and all the new martyrs and confessors of Russia, of our holy and God-bearing fathers, Anthony, Theodosia, Viktiev, James, Sergei, the abbot, Rodnej, and Seraphim of Sarov, Job, the abbot and wonder worker, Pachai, of the holy righteous, John of Kronstadt, of the holy blessed, Xenia of Petersburg, our venerable and God-bearing fathers, Herman of Alaska, Paisi, Gospowski, of the Christ, and Brosi, and the other elders of Okina, of the Holy Hierarchs, Innocent of Moscow, Nicholas of Japan, John of Shanghai and San Francisco, and Joan of Manchuria, of our fathers among the saints, Philaret of New York, and Nicolina of Lesna, of the Holy Right, and of the Holy, the Center of the Holy Spirit upon the Holy Apostles, and of the Holy and Righteous Ancestors of God, Joachim, and of all the saints, make our prayer acceptable, grant us remission of sins, shelter us from the shelter of thy wings, drive away from us every enemy and adversary, and make our life peaceful, Lord. Have mercy on us in all thy world, and save our souls, for thou art good and the lover of mankind.
Amen.
The sixth song, being heard of the power of thine own Holy Spirit.
Be ignorant of the power of thy Holy Spirit, which was found under thy apostles, O Lord. Thou didst imagine that the persecuted of us will be drunkenness, but we who are established by them, speak us unceasing. Take not thy Holy Spirit from us, we pray, O friend.
Create me a clean heart, O God,
and renew all my spirit within me. O Lord, let me send up the Holy Spirit, which I know of thine apostles, make them to speak with other tongues, Hence the strange wonder was thought to be drunkenness by the unbelievers. But to the believers it was a cause of salvation. Wherefore we beseech thee to keep us also worthy of his illumination, O Friend of man.
Cast me not away from thy presence,
and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. O heavenly King, O Comforter, Spirit of truth, Lord, everywhere present and filled with all things, treasury of good gifts and giver of life, come and abide in us and cleanse us of all impurity and save our souls, O good One.
Glory hold now in the eightfold.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Of old, the tongues were confounded because of the audacity in the building of the tower. But now the tongues are made wise because of the glory of divine knowledge. They're not condemned the impious because of their offense. And here Christ hath enlightened the fishermen by the Spirit. At that time the confusion of tongues was wrought for punishment. But now the concord of tongues hath been inaugurated for the salvation of our souls.
Now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace, O Master, and give me thy word, for mine eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all peoples, a light of revelation for the Gentiles, and the glory of thy people Israel. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, blot out our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit me, O our infirmities, for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Wine and oil, and multiply them in this town and all their world, and sanctify the faithful people, for thou that is blessed and sanctify all things of Christ our God. And unto thee be sent of glory, filled with thy virgin and Father, and all holy, good, and life creating spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord, henceforth and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord, henceforth and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord, henceforth and forevermore. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. In the Lord shall my soul be praised. Let the meek hear and be glad. O magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he heard me, and delivered me from all my tribulations. Come unto him and be anointed. And your faces shall not be ashamed. This poor and proud and the Lord heard him, and saved him out of all his tribulations. The angel of the Lord will encamp round about them that fear him, and will deliver them. O taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that hopeth in him. O fear the Lord, all ye his saints, for there is no want in them that fear him. Rich men have turned poor and bought poverty, but they that seek the Lord shall not be deprived of any good.
The blessing of the Lord be upon you through his grace and love for mankind, always done ever unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill among men. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill among men. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill among men. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. O Lord, why are they multiplied that afflict me? Many rise up against me. Many say unto my soul, there is no salvation for him in his God. But thou, Lord, art my helper, my glory, and the lifter up of my head. I cried to the Lord my voice, and he heard me out of his holy mountain. I lay me down and slept. I woke, for the Lord will help me. I will not be afraid of 10,000s of people that set themselves against me round about. Arise, O Lord, save me, O my God, for thou hast been all thou cause are mine enemies. The teeth of sinners hast thou broken. Salvation is of the Lord, thy blessings upon thy people. I lay me down and slept. I woke, for the Lord will help me. O Lord, rebuke me not in thine anger, nor chasten me in thy wrath. For thine arrows are fastened in me, and thou hast laid thy hand heavily upon me. There is no healing in my flesh in the face of thy wrath, but there is no peace in my bones in the face of my sins. My iniquities are risen higher than my head, as the heavy burden of they pressed heavily upon me. My bruises are become noisome and corrupt in the face of my folly. I have been wretchedly bowed down until the end, all the day long I went with downcast face, for my loins are filled with mockings, and there is no healing in my flesh. I am afflicted and humbled exceedingly, I have roared for the groaning of my heart. Lord, before thee is all my desire, my groaning is not hid from thee. My heart is troubled, my strength hath failed me, the light of mine eyes, even this is not with me. My friends and my neighbors drew now over against me, and stood at my near, so kin stood afar off. They that set after my soul use violence, and they that sought evil before me spake vain things and craftiness, all the day long did they meditate. But as for me, like a deaf man, I heard them not, and this is a speechless man that openeth not his mouth. I became as a man that heareth not, and then hath in his mouth the reproaches. For in thee am I hoped, O Lord, that will hearken unto me, O Lord my God. For I said that never my enemies rejoice over me, yet my feet were shaken, those men spake boastful words against me. For I am ready for scourges, and my sorrows continually before me. For I will declare my iniquity, and I will take heed concerning my sin. But my enemies live and are made stronger than I am, and they hate me unjustly or multiply. They that render me evil for good slander me, because I pursue goodness. Forsake me not, O Lord my God, depart not from me. Be attentive unto my help, O Lord, and my salvation. Forsake me not, O Lord, my God, depart not from me. Be attentive unto my help, O Lord, of my salvation. O God, my God, to thee I rise early at dawn, my soul hath thirsted for thee. How often my flesh longed after thee in the land barren and trodden in the water. So in the sanctuary I may pray before thee to see thy power and thy glory, for thy mercy is better than lives. My lips shall praise thee. So shall I bless thee in my life, and in thy name will I lift up my hands. As with marrow and fatness of my soul be filled, with lips of rejoicing shall my mouth praise thee. If I remember thee on my bed at the dawn, I meditated on thee. For thou art become my helper, and the shelter of thy wings will I rejoice. My soul hath leaped after thee, thy right hath been quick to help me. But as for these in vain, if they sought after my soul, they shall go into the uttermost parts of the earth, they shall be surrendered to the edge of the sword, portions for foxes shall they be. But the king shall be glad in God, everyone shall be praised, as sweareth by him, for the mouth that has stopped and speak unjust things. After dawn I meditated on thee, for thou art become my helper, in the shelter of thy wings will I rejoice. My soul hath leaped after thee, thy right hath been quick to help me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Lord God of my salvation, by day, by night, by night before thee, let my prayer come before thee, bow down thine ear to my supplication. For filled with evils is my soul, and my life unto Hades hath drawn none. I am counted with them that go down into the pit, and become as a man without help, free among the dead, like the bodies of the slain that sleep in the grave, and they will never snow more, and they are cut off with my hand. They lay me in the lowest pit in darkness, in the shadow of death. Against me is thy anger made strong, and all thy billows hast thou brought upon me. Thou hast removed my friends afar from me. They made me an abomination to themselves. I have been delivered up and have not come forth. Mine eyes have grown weak from poverty. I have cried unto thee, O Lord, the whole day long. I stretch out my hands unto thee. Nay, for the dead wilt thou work wonders. For shall physicians raise them up that they may give thanks unto thee. Nay, shall any in the grave tell of thy mercy and of thy truth and that destruction. Nay, shall thy wonders be known in that darkness, thy righteousness in a land that is forgotten. But as for me unto thee, O Lord, have I cried, in the morning shall my prayer come before thee. Wherefore, O Lord, dost thou cast off my soul, and turnest thy face away from me. A poor man am I, and the troubles of my youth, having been exalted, I was humbled and brought to distress. Thy fears have passed upon me, and thy terrors have sorely troubled me. They came round about me like water all the day long, and compassed me about together. Thou hast removed afar from me friend and neighbor, my acquaintances, because of my misery. Lord God of my salvation, by day, by pride, by night before thee, let my prayer come before thee, bow down thine ear to my supplication. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all that he hath done for thee, who is gracious unto all thine iniquities, who healeth all thine infirmities, who redeemeth thy life from corruption, who crowneth thee with mercy and compassion, who fulfilleth thy desire with good things. Thy youth should be renewed as the eagles. The Lord performeth deeds of mercy and executeth judgment for all them that are wrong. He hath made his ways known unto Moses and to the sons of Israel the things that he hath willed. Compassionate and merciful is the Lord, long-suffering and plenteous in mercy. Not to the end will he be angered, not unto eternity will he be wrong. Not according to our iniquities hath he dealt with us, neither according to our sins hath he rewarded us. For according to the height of heaven from the earth, the Lord has made his mercy prevail over them that fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our iniquities from us. Like as they found with compassion upon his son, so with the Lord had compassion upon them that feared him. For he knoweth whereof we are made, he hath remembered that we are dust. As for man, his days are as the grass. As a flower of the field, so shall he blossom forth. For when the wind is passed over, then it should be gone, and long will it know the place thereof. But the mercy of the Lord is from eternity, even into eternity, upon them that fear him. And his righteousness is upon sons of sons, upon them that keep his testimony and remember his commandments to do them. The Lord in heaven hath prepared his throne, and his kingdom ruleth over all. Blessed Lord are his angels, mighty in strength, that perform his word, to hear the voice of his words. Blessed Lord are his hosts, his ministers, that do his will. Blessed Lord are his works, every place of his dominion. Blessed Lord, O my soul, every place of his dominion. Blessed Lord, O my soul. Lord, hear my prayer, give ear to my supplication, thy truth, hearken to me in thy righteousness. And enter not to judgment with thy servant, for thy sight shall no man living be justified. For the enemy hath persecuted my soul. He hath humbled my life down to the earth. He hath sat me in darkness as those have been long dead. My spirit within me has become despondent. Within me my heart is troubled. I remember days of old. I meditate on all thy works. I pondered on the creations of thy hands. I stretch forth my hands unto thee. My soul thirsteth after thee like a waterless land. Quickly hear me, O Lord, my spirit hath fainted away. Turn not thy face away from me, lest it be like to do that I put down into the pit. Cause me to hear thy mercy in the morning, for thee am I put my hope. Cause me to know, O Lord, the way wherein I should walk, for to thee am I lifted up my soul. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord, to thee am I fled for refuge. Teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the light of uprightness, for thy name's sake, O Lord, shall not quicken me. In thy righteousness shall thou bring my soul out of affliction, and thy mercy shall thou utterly destroy mine enemies. Thou shalt cut off all them that afflict my soul, for I am thy servant. Hearken to me, O Lord, thy righteousness, and enter not to judgment with thy servant. Hearken unto me, O Lord, thy righteousness, and enter not to judgment with thy servant. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God.
In peace let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, the good state of the Lord, churches of God, and union of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy temple and for those with faith, reverence, and fear of God enter herein, let us pray to the Lord. For the Orthodox Episcopate of the persecuted Russian Church, for our Lord the Most Reverend Archbishop Tikhon, our Lord the Most Reverend Bishop Stefan, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the suffering Russian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and the diaspora, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That you may deliver his people from the bitter torment of the godless authority and confirm in us oneness of mind, brotherly love, and piety. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this land, its God-fearing authorities and armed forces, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this town, for every city and country, and the faithful who dwell therein, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For seasonable weather, abundance of the fruits of the earth, and peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick, the suffering, the imprisoned, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be delivered from all tribulation, wrath, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling your remembrance, our most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, of all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God.
Through thee, O Lord.
For unto thee is due all glory, honor, and worship to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
In the eighth tone, God is the Lord, and hath appeared unto us, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, and give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever.
Is the Lord and hath appeared unto us. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord.
Surrounding me, they compassed me, and by the name of the Lord I warded them off.
Locus body of Pisciana, locus of infratico in apostol.
I shall not die, but live, and I shall tell the works of the Lord.
God is the Lord and hath appeared unto us. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord.
The stone which the builders rejected, the same has become the head of the corner. This is the Lord's doing, and is marvelous in our sight.
Blessed art thou, O Christ our God, who hast shown forth the vision.
His name's sake. For though I should walk in the midst of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they have comforted me. Thou hast prepared a table before me in the presence of them that afflict me. Thou hast anointed my head with oil, thy cup which filled me, how excellent it is. Thy mercy shall pursue me all the days of my life. I will dwell in the house of the Lord unto length of days. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in remembrance, our most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious, that he filled, all us and every Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another, and all our life unto Christ our God. For good and man, loving God, art thou, and unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
O ye faithful, let us keep and celebrate most radiantly this post-festival and last feast. This is the day of Pentecost, which doth fulfill the appointed time of the promise. For on this day the fire of the good comforter straightway came on earth, as though in form of tongues, and enlightened the disciples, and proved them heaven's emissions. Behold, the comforter's light is come, and hath illumined the whole world. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and into the ages of ages. Amen. Coming down to those on earth, the Holy Spirit's spring was seen in the form of fiery streams of fortune spiritually to all, as it bedewed and enlightened the Lord's apostles. And thus the fire became a cloud, bedewing them, filling them with light, and raining flames on them. And through them grace has been now shaped as by fire and water and very truth. Behold, the Comforter's light has come, and hath illumined the whole world.
Praise ye the name of the Lord. All ye servants, praise the Lord. Alleluia. Blessed is the Lord our God, who has taken Jerusalem. Alleluia. O ye saints of the Lord, our God, alleluia, alleluia. For the earth is yours forever. Alleluia.
Thank you.
strengthened the work of his hands. And all the might of them by the Spirit of his mouth. We thank him.
Give ear unto my supplication.
Thy good Spirit shall lead me in the land of all uprightness.
Thy good Spirit shall lead me
in the land of all uprightness.
Let us pray to the Lord
for have mercy.
More holy art thou, Lord God, thou restest in the saints. And unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let every breath praise the Lord.
Let every breath praise the Lord.
Praising God and his saints, praise him in the firmament of his power.
Let every breath praise the Lord.
Let every breath
praise the Lord.
And that you will vouchsafe unto us the hearing of the Holy Gospel, let us pray to the Lord God.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Let us right, let us hear the Holy Gospel, peace be to all.
And to thy Spirit.
The reading is from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
Let us attend. The same day, evening being the first day of the week, when the doors were shut where the disciples were assembled for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in the midst and said unto them, peace be unto you. When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples were glad when they saw the Lord. So Jesus said unto them again, peace be unto you, as the Father hath sent me, so send I you. And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, receive ye the Holy Spirit. Whosoever sins ye forgive, they are forgiven. But whosoever sins ye retain, they are retained.
Glory to thee, O Lord,
glory
to thee.
Have mercy on me, O God, according to thy great mercy, and according to the multitude of thy compassions, blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my iniquity, my sin is ever before me. Against me have I sinned and done this evil before thee, that thou mightst be justified by words of prevail when thou art judge. Behold, I was conceived in iniquity since my mother bare me. Behold, thou hast loved truth, hidden secret things of thy wisdom hast been made manifest unto me. Thou shalt sprinkle me with hyssop, and I shall be made clean. Thou shalt wash me, and I shall be made whiter than snow. Thou shalt make me to hear joy and gladness. The bones of the humble, they shall rejoice. Turn thy face away from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and with thy governing spirit establish me. I shall teach transgressors thy ways, that godly shall turn back unto thee. Heal me from blood guiltiness, O God, the God of my salvation. My tongue shall rejoice in thy righteousness. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, my mouth shall declare thy praise. For if thou hast desired sacrifice, I have given it. With whole burnt offerings thou shalt not be pleased. A sacrifice unto God is a broken spirit. Heart that is broken and humbled, God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, thy good pleasure, inside of the walls of Jerusalem be builded. Then shalt thou be pleased with a sacrifice of righteousness and oblation whole burnt offerings. Then shall they offer bullocks upon thine altar.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Through the prayers of the apostles, O merciful One, what of the multitude of our transgressions? O now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Through the grace of the Theotokos, O merciful One, what of the multitude of our transgressions? Have mercy on me, O God, according to thy great mercy. And according to the multitude of thy compassions, blot out my transgression. O heavenly King, comfort your spirit of truth, who art everywhere present and fillest all things, treasury of good gifts and giver of love, come and abide in us, and cleanse us of all impurity, and save our souls, O
Save, O God, thy people, and bless thine inheritance. Visit thy world with mercy and compassion. Exalt the horde of Orthodox Christians, and send out upon us thine abundant mercies. Through the of our Immaculate Lady, Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, through the power of precious and life-giving cross, through the mediation of the heavenly Bodhis, host of the ever glorious prophet, Father, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, lovable apostles, our fathers, among the saints, and great ecumenical teachers and hierarchs, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, and John Chrysostom, of our Father among the Saints, Nicholas the Wonder Worker, Archbishop of Munich, and Nicaea, of Holy, equally Apostles, Putting, and Trill, Teachers of the Slavs, of the Holy Right Believing, equally Apostles, Great Prince of the Demon, and the Blessed Princes of Russia, Olga, of our Fathers among the Saints, the Wonder Workers of all Russia, Michael, Peter, Alexis, Jonah, Philip, Hermogenes, Macarius, Demetrius, Mitrophon, Tikhon, Theodosios, and Tertullian, Innocent, and John, of all the Arab martyrs and professors, Tikhon, Patriarch of Moscow, Vladimir of Kiev, Benjamin of Petrograd, Joseph of Petrograd, Peter of Katitsa, Kirill of Kazan, Agafanga, Yaroslava, underneath the Permermogenes of the Poles, the priest John, Peter, and Philosoph, and all the new Arab martyrs and professors of Russia, of the holy, glorious, victorious martyrs, the holy, glorious, great martyr, Trophy Baron, Wonder Worker George, the holy, great martyr, Mihaila Pantaleon, the holy, great martyr, Barbara, of the Holy Right Believing Russian Princes and Passion Bearers, Boris Kleb and Igor, of the Holy Right Believing Passion Bearers, Tsarmata Nikolai, Tsaritsa, Alexandra, Tsarevich Alexei, the Royal Martyrs, Olga, Tatiana, Maria, and Anastasia, of the Holy Venerable Nun Martyrs, Grand Duchess Elizabeth and Nun Barbara, and all the new martyrs and professors of Russia, of our Holy God bearing Fathers, Anthony and Theodosia, the Kiev Caves, Sergei the Abbot Radnej and Seraphim of Sarov, Job the Abbot and Wonderworker Pachai of the Holy Righteous, John of Kronstadt, of the Holy Blessed Xenia of Petersburg, of Venerable God bearing Fathers, Herman of Alaska, Paisi Velikov, Kirill Macarius, and Porosi and the Elders of Optina, the Holy Hierarchs, Innocent of Moscow, Nicholas of Japan, John of Shanghai and San Francisco, and Joan of Manchuria, Philaret of New York, and the Blessed Xenia of Katrina of Lesna, and of the Holy Descent of the Holy Spirit upon the Holy Apostles, and of holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim, and Anne of all saints, we pray that you look plenteous in mercy. Hearken unto our sins, the prayer of thee, and have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, 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 Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Through the mercies and compassions of love for mankind, of thine only begotten Son, of whom thou art blessed, give them most holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. As thou hast aforetime promised thy disciples, thou hast indeed sent forth the comforting spirit of Christ, and has shined light upon the world, O friend of man. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. That which was proclaimed in the prophets and the law of old hath been fulfilled, for on this day the grace of the divine spirit is poured out on all the faithful. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The august and venerable Mount spake, as for you, my friends, you shall not be forsaken. Proceeded together upon the Father's most high throne, I shall pour forth the abundant grace of the Spirit upon those who desire to be enlightened, both now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Having reached the end, the word was most precise, but calm the heart. For having accomplished his work, Christ, as he promised, blessed his friends by bestowing upon them the Spirit in a mighty wind and with tongues of fire.
Offered by the new high cloud, he that was slow of tongue, proclaimed the law written by Paul. For having shaken off the impurity from the oil of his mind, he beholded him that is, and he is initiated into the knowledge of the Spirit, while giving praise with heart inspired songs. Now, fix me unto thy disciples, O Christ. Tarry ye in Jerusalem till ye be filled with power from on high. And I will send you another comforter, lying unto me, who is my Spirit and the Spirit of the Father. In whom ye shall be established.
Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. When the power of the divine Spirit came down in divine manner, united to one concord, the divided voice of them that of old have evenly seen together, it had been wise and faithful with the knowledge of the Trinity, wherein we have been established. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. When the power of the divine Spirit came down in divine manner, united to one concord, the divided voice of them that of old had evenly agreed together, and it hath made wise the man faithful with the knowledge of the Trinity wherein we have been established. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Incomprehensible is the most divine sovereignty, for it hath made eloquent the unlearned men of the sea, who with their speech stopped the mouth of the sophists, and brought out from the deepest night countless peoples by the lemon flame of the Spirit. Both now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. From the unbegotten lumen essence proceedeth the effulgent, all-affecting, imperishable resplendence, whose fiery sound in Zion, through the sun now made manifested to the nations, the consubstantial beacon light of the Father's authority.
Only the
veil
of the carpenter's son, who of old by the prophet's spirit, unto the mighty divine God of knowledge, loose the fetters of the childless womb, and the upper way we do not approach
you. Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in remembrance, our most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos, all this and ever Virgin Mary, all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another, and all our life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O
for thou art our God, and to thee we send our glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
They who had once been afraid became emboldened and filled with joy when they left that love of the Lord and Savior, when the Spirit descended on this day from heaven. He came and rested upon the disciples' heads, and he spake unto the people who had been loved. For lo, comes as it were a fire, and was seen divided in their midst, and yet this fire consumed them not, but refreshed and revealed on them.
When the world of prayer seemed like calling in the last days of Christ, he cried out, I have heard of thy wife, O Lord, that thou hast come to save all thine anointed.
Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. He that spake to the prophets and was proclaimed through the law, even the very God, the Comforter, is made known today to the servants and witnesses of the word who have heard thy word in perfect. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. Bearing the evident signs of divinity, the Spirit was divided among the apostles by fire, inspired them with the power to speak in foreign tongues, possessing divine power from the Father, he cometh of his own accord. Glory to the thee, our God, glory to thee. Having mingled by thy word the divine labor of regeneration, compound nature, O word of God, thou causest a stream to rain down upon me from thy pierced and corrupt side, and thou seemest me with the fervor of the Spirit. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. All things bow their knee before the Comforter and the offspring of the Father and the consubstantial Father, for they acknowledge in three persons the one infallible, unapproachable, and timeless essence, for the grace of the Spirit has shined forth illumination, both now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. By ye be all perfected by the supremely divine sovereignty, as many of you as offer adoration to the essence of threefold splendor. For Christ is our benefactor, supernaturally perfected, that illumineth us unto salvation, by shaking the plenitude of the grace of the Spirit.
O King of kings, even thou, art from the only one, O Word who comest forth from the only uncaused Father, thou, as our benefactor, didst not willingly send thy equipotent Spirit unto the apostles, who sing glory to thy power. The Spirit of salvation, O Lord, who was conceived in the loins of the prophets because of their fear of thee, and was brought forth upon the earth to purify the hearts of the apostles, and is renewed in a better in the faithful, for thy commandments are light and peace.
Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. This power which has come down today is the good Spirit, God's Spirit of wisdom, the Spirit that proceeded from the Father, through the Son, is being manifested in us, the faithful. He is imparted to those in whom he dwelt by nature of his holiness, wherein he is discerned. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. This power which has come down today is the good Spirit, God's Spirit of wisdom, the Spirit that proceeded from the Father, through the Son, is being manifested to us, the faithful. He is imparted to those in whom he dwelt by nature of his holiness, wherein he is discerned. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was pleasing unto him by his own authority, this unsubordinated Spirit descended from the Father, making the apostles wise with tongues and confirming with his seal the vivifying word. The Savior spake of him, who hath the Father's strength and is one in likeness with him, both now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. The supreme ruler of God, the Word, healed the apostles' minds of sin and prepared them to be an immaculate dwelling place for himself. Now there dwelt in them the light of the Spirit, who is equipotent and consubstantial.
O ye children of the church's likeness, is light unto light, receiving the fire breathing you of the Spirit, which is a redeeming purification of offenses. For now hath the law gone forth from Zion, even the Spirit's grace in the form of tongues of fire. O us by the dampness of the cares of life, and cast into the sins that sail with thee, and being thrown to the soul corrupting beast, like Jonas I cried unto thee, O Christ. Draw me up out of the depth that breathe
death. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. Thou hast abundantly poured forth of thy Spirit upon all flesh, even as thou hast saying, all creation is filled with thy knowledge, O Lord. For thou, the Son, hast come forth immutably from the Father, and the Spirit indivisibly proceeded. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. Thou hast abundantly poured forth of thy Spirit upon all flesh, even as thou hast said, all creation is filled with thy knowledge, O Lord. For the Son is come forth immediately from the Father, and the Spirit indivisibly proceeded. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O ruler of all, renew within us the cherished upright Spirit, that we may eternally have him who proceedeth from the Father, with whom he is most perfectly united. He is a breaking, purging away hateful, polluted matter, and cleansing our minds of defilement, both now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. As for the apostles in Zion, who awaited thy coming, O Spirit, thou with thy fiery breath hast consecrated them with a coveted dignity, even the knowledge of the Word begotten of the Father, which swiftly exposed the cruel paddle of the heathen's babbling.
Thou hast shone forth from the Virgin, as forgiveness and salvation for us, O Christ, Master. And like as Jonas was
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
help us, save us, and sustain us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in remembrance, our most holy, most pure, most blessed glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary of all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God. For thou art the King of peace and the Savior of our souls, and unto thee we send up glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Once when he descended and confounded the tongues, the Most High divided the nations, and when he divided the tongues of fire, he called all men into unity, and with one accord he glorified the Holy Spirit.
Grant thou speedy and lasting consolation to thy servants, O Jesus, when our spirits are despondent. Be thou not parted from our souls when they be in affliction. Be thou not far from our minds when we are in perils, but do thou ever anticipate our needs. Draw nigh to us, draw nigh, O thou who art everywhere present, and even as thou art ever with thy apostles, thus do thou also united to thyself, us all, us who long for thee, O compassionate one. That being united with thee, we may praise and glorify thine all Holy Spirit.
When the holy children were cast into the furnace of fire, they changed the fire into dew by their unity as they cried out thus, Blessed art thou, O Lord, the God of our fathers.
Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. When the apostles spake eloquently concerning the divine and mighty deeds, the Spirit's power whereby the Trinity is known as the one God of our fathers was thought to be drunkenness by them that believed not. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. In an orthodox manner, let us proclaim with divine authority the undivided essence, God the beginningless Father and the Word and the Spirit to our equal authority, and let us cry, Blessed art thou, the God of our fathers. Glory to the Father, glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. Ignorant of the words spoken by the prophets, the mindless called in drunkenness from wine when they heard the apostles speak in strange tongues, but we the pious cry unto thee in a God-inspired manner. Blessed art thou, renewer of the whole world. Glory to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit. Joel, the divinely inspired seer, thundered forth an oracle spoken by the supremely divine and sovereign word. They upon whom I shall pour out my spirit will cry out together, Blessed art thou, brilliant, thy resplendent nature, both now and ever and into the ages of ages. Amen. The third hour on the singular day of the Lord was made rich with grace that we might be taught to honor three hypostases in oneness of authority.
The unison of instrumental music declared that all should worship the lifeless image wrought of gold, but the light-bearing grace of the Comforter now teach us to cry out in reverence, Holy Trinity. Equipment and beginningless blessed art thou. The bush that was unconsumed by fire on Sinai spake unto the dark with appointed and articulate Moses, and may God known unto him. And see, our God shall forth the three children who chanted hymns to the unconsumed by fire. O all ye his words, praising the Lord and supremely exalting unto all the ages.
Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. When the vivifying violet wing of the Holy Spirit came from on high, resounding into vision in the form of fire, and constantly spake eloquently concerning the mighty deeds of God, all your words, praise you, the Lord, supremely exalted unto all these ages. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. Even ascend not that untouchable mountain, nor fear the awesome fire, come, let us stand on Mount Zion, in the city of the living God, and now form one fire with the Spirit bearing disciples. All your words, praise you, the Lord, supremely exalted unto all these ages. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. The Spirit coming down in likeness of tongues of fire caused the apostles to remember the more concerning doctrines which Christ heard from the Father and declared unto them. And creation once alienated, but now reconciled, but praise thee, the blessed one. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Thou camest as a Savior to invest the apostles with the life which came of itself, being Lord in light and giver of light. Thou hast distributed thy suppliants as it were a cherished priest, but pray for Spirit. Both now and ever in the age of ages. Amen. The Spirit-filled mouths of the prophets sang of thy advent to the body of guardian ruler. Now thy uncreated, co-formative, demiurgic, equivalent spirit which proceedeth from the paternal bosom, which thou hast sent to confirm the worship of the incarnation.
Praise be as we worship the Lord. Praise be as we bring the exalted Him unto all men. And thou shalt the Father see you, and thou shalt be sighted to see you. Thou shalt all the good things of the earth be unto you. Thou shalt be in the earth and all creation thou hast made of blood. The only Savior and Creator of all that's not yet known. O God, O Lord, how the Spirit of the Lord has revealed to us, and in the flesh of the Word who devoured us all things, O Thou Mother who has not the bread of
Lord our God.
Holy is the Lord our God.
Lord, holy is the Lord our God. The Holy Spirit hath ever been and is and shall be, neither beginning nor ending, but
but he is ever ranked and numbered together with the Father and the Son. He is life and life creating, light and light bestowing, by nature good and the source of goodness. Through him the Father is known and the Son is glorified, and thereby all men acknowledge a single sovereignty, single covenant, one adoration of the Holy Trinity.
Praise him in timbrel and dance, praise him in strings and flute.
The Holy Spirit is light and life, and the living and noetic fountain, a spirit of wisdom, a spirit of understanding, a good and upright and noetic spirit, presiding in power and purging offenses. He is God and deified. He is fire issuing from fire, speaking, working, distributing the gifts, through whom all the prophets and the apostles of God and all the martyrs receive their crowns. Strange as this report, strange and new this sight, a fire divided that these gifts may be apportioned.
Praise him with tuneful symbols, praise him with symbols of jubilation, let every breath praise the Lord.
The Holy Spirit is light and life, and a living noetic fountain, a spirit of wisdom, a spirit of understanding, a good and upright, a noetic spirit, presiding in power and purging offenses. He is God and doth deify, he is fire issuing from fire, speaking, working, distributing the gifts, through whom all the prophets and the apostles of God and all the martyrs receive their crowns. Strange is this report, strange and new this sight, a fire divided, that these gifts may be a portion.
Glory both now in the sixth tone.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O heavenly King, O comfort your spirit of truth, who art everywhere present and filled with all things, treasury of good gifts and giver of life, come and abide in us, and cleanse us of all impurity, and save our souls from good.
Glory to the earth shall us the light.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace and good will of men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee. We give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, and Holy Spirit. O Lord, God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Now that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Now that sittest at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord of Jesus Christ, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. Every day will I bless thee, and I will praise thy name forever and forever and ever. How shameful, Lord, to keep us this day without sin. Blessed art thou, O Lord, the God of our fathers, and praised and glorified is thy name unto the ages. Amen. Let thy mercy, O Lord, be upon us, and pardon us, we have hope in thee. Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me thy statutes. Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me thy statutes. Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me thy statutes. Lord, thou hast been our refuge in generation and generation. I said, O Lord, have mercy on me, heal my soul, for I have sinned against thee. O Lord, unto thee have I fled for refuge, teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. For in thee is the fountain of life, and my light shall be seen light. O continue thy mercy unto them that know thee. Holy God, holy, mighty, holy, immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy, mighty, holy, immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy, mighty, holy, immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Holy immortal, have mercy on us. fishermen as supremely wise, ascending down upon them the Holy Spirit, and through them didst draw the world into thy net. O lover of mankind, glory be to thee.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to thy great mercy, we pray thee. Pardon and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the Orthodox Episcopal of the persecuted Russian Church, for our Lord, the most reverend Archbishop Peacock, our Lord, the most reverend Bishop Stefan, and for all our brethren in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for the suffering Russian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and the diaspora, and for their salvation.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray and deliver his people from the bitter torment of the godless authority and confirm in us oneness of mind, brotherly love, and piety.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray from this land its God-fearing authorities and armed forces.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the blessed and ever-memorable founders of this holy temple and for all our fathers and brethren gone and rest before us, and the Orthodox here never relate to sleep.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon, and remission of the sins of the servants of God. Brethren of this holy temple,
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Again, we pray for those who bring offerings and good works in this holy and all venerable temple, for those who minister and those who chant, and for all the people here present who wait to be great and abundant mercy.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
For merciful and man loving God, art thou and unto thee who sent of glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. Thou never let the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us complete our morning prayer to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
That the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Angel of peace, a faithful guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Pardon and remission of our sins and offenses, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Things good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
A Christian ending to our life, painless, blameless, peaceful, and in good defense before the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask.
Grant this, O Lord.
Calling to remembrance our most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious, steady, fed, hope, the same Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God.
To thee,
our divine mercy, compassion, and love for mankind, and unto thee we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be to all,
and to thy Spirit.
Let us bow our heads unto the Lord. For thine it is to show mercy to save us, O our God, and unto thee we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Wisdom,
Father, bless.
Even as is blessed, Christ our God, who is now and ever, unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Establish, O God, the holy Orthodox faith and Orthodox Christians, unto the ages of ages.
Almost holy Theotokos, save us.
More honorable than the cherubim and the uncompared, more glorious than the seraphim, who without corruption gave his birth to God the Word, the very Theotokos, the new ignite.
Christ, God, our hope, glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of the ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Father,
in Christ, our true God, who sent down from heaven the most Holy Spirit in forms of tongues of fire upon his holy disciples and apostles, through the intercessions of his most pure mother and all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us.
Orthodox Episcopate of the persecuted Russian Church, our Lord, the most reverend Archbishop Tito, our Lord, the most reverend Bishop Stefan, the brethren of this holy temple and all Orthodox Christians, preserve, O Lord, for days.
O come, let us worship God, our King. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ, our King and God. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, our King and God. Unto my words give ear, O Lord, hear my cry, attend to the voice of my supplication, O my King and my God. For unto thee will I pray, O Lord, in the morning thou shalt hear my voice. In the morning shall I stand before thee, and thou shalt look upon me. For not a God that dwells iniquity art thou. He that worketh evil shall not dwell near thee, nor shall transgressors abide before thine eyes. Thou hast hated all them that work iniquity. Thou shalt destroy all them that speak a lie. A man that is bloody deceitful shall the Lord abhor. But as for me, in the multitude of thy mercy shall I go into thy house. I shall worship from thy holy temple in fear of thee. O Lord, guide me in the way of thy righteousness, because of mine enemies make straight my way before thee. For in their mouth there is no truth, their heart is vain. Their throat is an open sepulchre, with their tongues have they spoken deceitfully. Judge them, O God. Let them fall down on account of their own devisings. According to the multitude of their uncountenance, cast them out when they have embittered thee, O Lord. Let all them be glad that hope in thee. They shall ever rejoice that thou shalt dwell among them. All shall glory in them that love thy name, for thou shalt bless the righteous. The Lord is what they shield of thy good pleasure, hast thou proud of us. Lord, thou hast been our refuge in generation to generation. For the mountains came to thee, and the earth was formed, and the world even from everlasting to everlasting thou art. For not bent away into lowliness, yet thou hast centered back the sons of men. For 1,000 years of thine eyes, O Lord, are but as yesterday that is passing as they watch in the night. Things of no account shall their years be. In the morning like grass shall man pass away. In the morning shall he bloom and pass away, and the evening shall he fall and grow withered and dry. For we have fainted away in thy wrath, and in thine anger have we been troubled. Thou hast set our iniquities before thee, our life spent is in the light of thy countenance. For all our days are faded away, and the night wrath are we fainted away. Our years have like a spider spun out their tail. It's for the days of our years, their span may be 80 years and 10. And if we be in strength, may have 80 years. What is more than these is toil and travail. For mildness has come upon us, and we shall be chastened. Who knoweth the might of thy wrath? Out of fear of thee, who can recount thy anger? So make thy right hand known to me, and to them that are in their heart instructed in wisdom. Return, O Lord, how long? Be thou treated concerning thy servants. We are filled in the morning with thy mercy, O Lord, we rejoice and we're glad. In all our days let us be glad for the days wherein thou didst humble us, for the years wherein we saw evils. And look upon thy servants and upon thy works, and do thou guide their sons. Let the brightness of the Lord our God be upon us, and the works of our hands. Do thou guide aright upon us, yea, the works of our hands, do thou guide aright. Of mercy and judgment will I sing unto thee, O Lord. I will chant and have understanding and blameless path. When wilt thou come unto me? I have walked in the innocence of my heart, in the midst of my house. I have no unlawful thing before mine eyes. The workers of transgressions I have hated. A crooked heart hath not cleaved unto me. It's for the wicked man who turned from me, I knew him not. Him that privily talked against his neighbor did I drive away from me. With him whose eye was proud and his heart insatiate, I did not eat. Mine eyes were upon the faithful, the Lamb, that they might sit with me. The man that walked in the blameless path, he ministered unto me. The proud doer dwelt not in the midst of my house. The speaker of unjust things prospered not before mine eyes. The morning I slew all the sinners of the land, utterly destroyed of the city of the Lord all them that work iniquity. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and into the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Blessed art thou, Christ our God, who has shown forth the fishermen as supremely wise by setting down upon them the Holy Spirit and through them has brought the world into thy name. O lover of mankind, glory be to thee, both now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. When shall we call thee, O thou that art full of grace? Heaven, for thou hast gone forth the sun of righteousness. Paradise, for thou hast blossomed forth the flower of immortality. Virgin, for thou hast remained incorrupt. Pure mother, for thou hast held in thy holy embrace the Son, the God of all. Do thou treat and do save our souls. My steps do thou direct according to thy saying, let no iniquity have dominion over me. Deliver me from the false accusation of men, and I will keep thy commandments. Make thy face to shine upon thy servant, and teach me thy statutes. Let my mouth be filled with thy praise, O Lord, that I may hymn thy glory and thy majesty all the day long. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, blot out our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Once when he descended and confounded the tongues, the Most High divided the nations. And when he divided the tongues of fire, he called all men into unity. With one accord we glorify the all-holy Spirit. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Thou at all times and every hour in heaven and on earth art worshipped and glorified, O Christ God, with long suffering, plenteous and mercy, most compassionate, who lovest the righteousness, mercy on sinners, who calls all to salvation with the promise of good things to come. Receive, O Lord, our prayers this hour and guide our life to thy commandments. Sanctify our souls, make chaste our bodies, correct our thoughts, purify our intentions, deliver us from every sorrow, evil, and pain. Comes the battle with thy holy angels, thy guardian, guided by their array, maintain to you, to the faith and all of thy unapproachable glory. For blessed art thou in the ages of ages. Amen. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. For all in the chair, we have the pure more glorious than the seraphim, without corruption, gave us birth to God the Word, the very Theotokos, thee do we magnify. In the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
God be merciful unto us, and shine the light of his countenance upon us, and be merciful unto us.
Amen.
O Christ, the true light, who enlightens and sanctifies every man that comes into the world, let the light of thy countenance be shined upon us, that in it we may see the unapproachable light, and guide our steps in the doing of thy commandments. Through the intercessions of thy most pure mother and of all the saints. Amen.
Be the champion leader with thy servants dedicate, a feast of victory and of thanksgiving. As once rescued out of soul, freight of Theotokos. But as Lord, one with light which is invisible, from all dangers that can be to God deliver us, Lord, we may find to thee, rejoice so bright of light.
Glory to thee, O Christ, God, our hope, glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Amen.
God, who sent down from heaven the most Holy Spirit in forms of tongues of fire upon his holy disciples and apostles, the intercessions of his most pure mother and of all the saints, have mercy on us.